Welcome to Microwave Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain magnetron with zero mode, pi mode, mode jumping, and how we can avoid mode jumping by having strapping method. So these are my session outlines where I'll explain how zero mode, pi mode is there in magnetron, and then I'll explain what is mode jumping in magnetron. And then to avoid mode jumping, how to have strapping in magnetron. So let us begin this session with first point, that is, first of all, how we can represent mode in magnetron. So if I say phi, that represents the relative phase change of AC electric field across adjacent cavities, then we can have phi, that is 2 pi n divided by capital N, where value of n, that could be 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 up to, it can be up to plus or minus n by 2. So what it means, there could be n by 2 number of modes of resonance can exist in n if n is even number. So there are total n by 2 number of modes which is possible. So when you observe magnetron, I have already explained magnetron basics and its working. If you have n is even number, in that case n by 2 number of modes, that is possible. Now see, if I consider a value over here where n is equals to 0, so if small n, that is equals to 0, in that case you will be finding phase is equals to, if you substitute value in this equation, then you will be finding phase is equals to 0. If phase is equals to 0, what it means, it this is 0 mode of magnetron. Now if I consider n is equals to n by 2, in that case you will be finding phase, that is 2 pi into capital N by 2 divided by capital N. So this n will get cancelled and this 2 will get cancelled, so that will result into pi. So phase is pi. What it means, this is what, pi mode of magnetron. So this is how we can have zero mode of magnetron or pi mode of magnetron by having a substitution of small n value. And based on that phase, we can justify how zero mode is there. Now when we talk about zero mode, it is not useful mode in magnetron. The reason is, where you will be finding energy is happening in anode cavity with zero phase difference. So there will be no generation of signal because of zero phase, as electric field is not having any phase. So first I'll explain you how pi mode is there and how it is so efficient. So let us discuss those things step by step. So when we talk about pi mode in magnetron, in this, adjacent anode cavity has 180 degree phase difference, as I have earlier calculated. Phi is equals to pi means it is 180 degree. So in this, adjacent anode cavity has 180 degree phase difference. When we talk about pi mode, it is most commonly used in magnetron. Why it is most commonly used in magnetron? The reason is, it is having maximum efficiency of operation at phase difference of 180 degree. And when you see magnetron, here one can see this magnetron which is operating at pi mode. What it means, these are anode cavities. These are anode cavities that one can see. Now all those cavities, that is having phase difference of 180 degree. Like see, if I say this plate is positive, then you'll be finding next plate that is negative. Then next plate that is positive, next plate is negative. So what it means, these all anode adjacent cavities, these all adjacent cavities apported by 180 degree phase difference. All adjacent cavities are apported by 180 degree phase. So that is what the exact understanding which is there with pi mode of operation. So this is what I have explained it with respect to electric field and magnetic field. Now let us discuss few more basics regarding this, so it will be more clear. Now see, as I have told, a magnetron when operated under pi mode, it gives maximum output power and desired frequency. So usually you'll be finding this pi mode of operation, that is most commonly used. It is most commonly used. Why? The reason is it has maximum output power and desired frequency, and it has maximum efficiency too. Now see, since there are 8 coupling cavities, you'll be finding there are different modes of oscillation which is possible. So what happens is, when oscillation is happening, at that time some modes are close to another. So when you have oscillation, some modes which are nearer to that pi mode, sometimes there will be switching of one mode to other mode. So because of switching of one mode to another mode, magnetron goes in jumping from one mode to another mode, and that is what called as mode jumping in magnetron. So it is what? Mode jump from one mode to other mode. So that happens sometime, as if you find frequency corresponding to mode is very nearer by. So if you want to avoid this, we should have a strapping. So strapping that is been utilized to avoid mode jumping. So in order to avoid mode jumping, we use strapping. Now what is strapping? So strapping consists two rings of heavy gauge wire connecting alternate poles. Like one can see here, these are two rings. Is one ring. I think it is clear to all now. This is one ring and this is second ring. So these two rings, that is what we are connecting it to alternate pole. Like one can observe here, if you see this ring, that is shoulder here. So after skipping one pole, you should shoulder it here. After skipping one pole, you should shoulder it here. One can see here, after skipping one pole, it have been shouldered here. So see, this is how one wire, that is what shouldered, that is what strapping, and second wire, that is what we are shouldering at other poles. So here we are strapping it, you can see it. Now what happens is, as you provide this trapping, you will be able to avoid mode jumping. So these are the poles that should be in phase with each other for pi mode, so that other than pi is rejected. So strapping that has been utilized to avoid mode jumping, and this is what all about basics of magnetron modes. So as I have told you, see, modes that is based on phase, and that is having this basic calculation, phi is equals to 2n 2 pi n by capital N. to n by 2 number of modes are possible. For 0 mode, phase is 0. For pi mode, phase is pi. And that is what happening at n is small n is equals to capital N by 2. And when you have pi mode, which is most efficient mode, that is most commonly used mode, which is having highest efficiency, at the time adjacent cavity, that is having 180 degree phase, and which one can see in the diagram even, adjacent cavity, that is there with the phase difference of 180 degree. And when you work out with magnetron, because of multiple cavities are there, magnetron may operate at different modes, and when it operates with different mode, it may jump from one mode to other mode. And as if it jumps from one mode to another mode, corresponding to frequency in that case, we can say it is what mode jumping, and it is undesired thing actually. So it should not happen. And to avoid this, we can have strapping in magnetron, where you take two gauge wires and you just connect it to poles of that anode cavity by skipping one pole. And for other wire, whatever skipped poles are there, where you need to connect it. So that is how we just provide strapping, which will be avoiding mode jumping. I hope that this session is clear to all. Thank you so much for watching this video. Give your valuable suggestions. Definitely, based on your suggestions, in future I'll place videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.